'Twas the night before Christmas, and from Angel Island to Green Hill, all were jolly and joyous, awaiting the holiday thrill. But high, high in the sky, in a place called the Ark, lived a hedgehog named Shadow, who was gloomy and dark. He despised the whole Yule. But why was Shadow so drab? Life had been so cruel since he was born in a lab. Was it that he might be a clone, or his girlfriend was shot? His memories weren't his own, he had been through a lot. "I despise that Christmas mess," he said with conviction. "I can't abide all that cheeriness, it's an awful addiction. With their singing and laughing, their feasting and boozing, why should one be carousing when one could be brooding?" Then a sinister scheme slipped into his head. Why should he be the one miserable when they could be miserable instead? He would stop Christmas this year, so they would know of his pain. He would spread sadness and fear. He was just a tad bit insane. So he chaos controlled from the Ark in a flash. To Station Square he rolled, he'd settle their hash. First off was Sonic, whom he thought quite an ass. Shadow stole all his rings and filled his sneakers with glass. Next up was Tails Shack on his villainous spree. He tossed his gifts in a sack and wrecked Tornadoes 1, 2, and 3. Poor Knuckles was sleeping when the Shadow had come. The Master Emerald was lifted as he dozed on his bum. Then the Sneaky Sneak snuck all the way to Club Rouge, and he stole her new panties, since the other smelled used. The Eggman was dreaming sweet dreams of great glory, when his Eggmobile was thieved by something red, black, and blurry. That crazy broad Amy awoke just in time to see someone pee-pee on her Sonic love shrine. The last house he hit belonged to Vanilla, a tawdry Dame Rabbit in a cozy little villa. But here is the place, oh that horrible sleaze, where our hedgehog disgrace met Cream and Chow Cheese. The bunny named Cream was no more than 4. She awoke from a dream to see Shadow at the door. With her Chow by her side, she approached the swift thief. She had tears in her eyes, which filled Shadow with grief.
"Why, oh why, Mr. Shadow, are you here in our house? You've broken the window and torn Mommy's blouse."
He looked at the tot, and he felt like a heel. His temper was hot, but her sadness was real. That doe-eyed little lass made him feel like a prick. In the next instant to pass, he saw Maria Robotnik. He was filled with such shame, and his rage soon was mild, and he saw his late flame in the face of that child.
"I beg of you, sweetness,"
her voice echoed in his brain.
"Christmas is kindness, not bringing others pain."
"But I have been wronged," the hedgehog retorted. "For revenge I have longed, and I'm just getting started."
"You have missed the point,"
Maria said softly.
"There is more to this holiday than tinsel and holly. It's a lot of stress making people jolly. It's a frustrating mess fraught with festive folly. Disappointment and pain mixed with pressure and tension, let alone the terrible drain when shopping is mentioned. But we take it in stride and all act quite manic, because deep down inside we all yearn for some magic. Life's a bitch, they all say. You know that quite well. But for one single day, we escape from that hell. Call it fantasy, yes it may be denial. Don't you want to be happy, if just for a while?"
Shadow had been wrong. He had now seen the light. He'd missed the truth all along. He must set everything right. With jet shoes ablazing, he returned all the loot. He fixed all he'd broken as fast as could scoot. Sure, Cream would need therapy, and Amy's rug stank of pee. But as the morning mist cleared, Christmas came for all to see. Shadow watched his spirit soared from his lonely home, the Ark. They giggled, danced, and poured, and for once, he felt a bit less dark. He misjudged the season, he pondered with a smile. This joy's for good reason, it makes suffering worthwhile. If you always felt low all the time that you had, how would you know the good from the bad?